right, all right, all right. This is Opio here, KBMS Radio. I got a real hot interview for you right now. Of course, you know we're kicking off our Juneteenth week right here on KBMS Radio. And who better to kick it off with than the national chair of Juneteenth right here, Reverend Dr. Ronnie Myers. How you doing, sir?
Okay, brother, how you doing today?
I'm doing well. Give us a little background on yourself. Who are you? How did you get into Juneteenth?
Well, my name is Reverend Dr. Ronald Myers. I'm the chairman of the National Juneteenth Holiday Campaign. And basically, we're working to make Juneteenth a national holiday observance in America. Juneteenth is the day, June 19, 1865, when the announcement was made by Union General Gordon Granger that all of our ancestors in enslavement were free. And that occurred there in the southwest section of the country, the last geographical vestige of slavery. And our ancestors heard the news, celebrated, and we've been celebrating with them ever since. And Juneteenth represents the end of slavery, and it took over 2.5 years for the news to travel Washington, where the Emancipation Proclamation was enforced January 1st to June 19, 1865.
So they called it Juneteenth because they said there were some people, if he arrived around the 13th to the 19th period, and so the word teenth is the kind of compromise dealing with that date. Is that right?
Well, you know, it's a combination of the word 19 and Juneteenth.
Okay.
In fact, if you talk to a lot of the older people in Texas in that area, they still call it the 19th of June. So it came together, those two terms, June 19th, Juneteenth.
Okay. Kind of like a lot of words were done during that time by black people. Why did it take 2.5 years after the Declaration Proclamation, where slavery was outlawed in the slave states, why did it take that long for it to get down to Texas?
Well, you know, there was a civil war going on, and certainly the slave owners wanted to let their slaves know they were free because of the importance they had in terms of working on those plantations. So it took the Union Army the time to get to that area, secure it, and where General Granger could make that announcement. And so it's a combination of the war, a combination of the fact that certainly the Southern slave owners did not want their slaves to be free. And so we had to wait 2.5 years, our ancestors. But when they heard the news, they celebrated, and we joined them in honoring them on 19th of June in celebration of our true day of independence as African Americans.
Now, how did Juneteenth first come about, and how did they celebrate it back then?
Well, we're going to go back to the first celebration when that announcement was made on June 19, 1865 in Galveston, Texas. Our ancestors celebrated right in the streets. They shouted for joy, they danced in the streets, and they had our first Juneteenth celebration. We've been celebrating ever since, 143 years of celebration. And it's celebrated with food, it's celebrated with music. Some people raise the flag, the Juneteenth flag. Some people read the Emancipation Proclamation. But certainly we all have come together on the 19th of June as the day that slavery ended across the United States.
Now, why hasn't, because slavery ending in this country, definitely, I think it was 1865 where the 13th Amendment was signed. The 14th Amendment 13th Amendment ended slavery, except if you're in jail. The 14th Amendment was citizenship, 15th Amendment, voting rights. Why isn't the Juneteenth or the ending of slavery a huge celebration around the country already?
Well, first of all, our ancestors did not celebrate the date that the 13th Amendment was passed.
Mm-hmm.
It's not really, we're not really sure if anyone was freed on June 19th illegally in terms of the Emancipation Proclamation, because remember, it only went that executive order that Abraham Lincoln only went to those states that were in rebellion and slavery. Did not cover other regions.
That's right.
But we honor our ancestors that when they heard the news on June 19, 1865, they celebrated in the streets, and we honored them by joining them in that celebration on the 19th of June. But actually, the legalese of it, in fact, it did take the 13th Amendment in terms of the actions taken by Congress to end slavery. But we honor our ancestors and joined them on the date June 19th when the announcement was made. We joined them in celebrating the end of slavery.
So why isn't this a huge holiday that would be equal to a Independence Day, especially when you talk about the ending of slavery, a war that had the fatalities more than any other war and all of the wars combined?
Well, you know, we had the, we as a group, those of us who celebrate Juneteenth, have decided on the 19th of June as the day that we're going to celebrate the end of our enslavement in America. Certainly, the Civil War, in terms of all the blood that was shed, and certainly we know it was not Abraham Lincoln for all of the free slaves. That was his main reason for having the Civil War. But basically, the Emancipation Proclamation was a military move to take away the workforce and have a tremendous impact into the economy in the South by having our ancestors be free. So we always consider it important to honor our ancestors as a priority when we talk about the date June 19, 1865 as the ending of slavery.
Mm-hmm. And at this point, you guys at the National Juneteenth Holiday Campaign have been doing the work of trying to make this a national holiday. And my question still is, why isn't it already a national commemoration holiday?
Well, brother, I mean, we live in a country that on July 4th, 1776, the country celebrates its birthday, and it's supposed to be Independence Day for the country, but George Washington was a slave owner, Thomas Jefferson was a slave owner, many of the founding fathers and first presidents of this country were slave owners. And so certainly, if you look at July 4th, 1776, as American Independence Day, it leaves out American of African descent. So we were not included in terms of the 4th of July, and we were not included in freedom in terms of the founding of this country. It took over 83 years after the country's first 4th of July when our last group of ancestors learned their freedom. And we also talked about the 13th Amendment, so we have to understand that in the history of America, the 4th of July was followed by the 19th of June. Now, both states complete the cycle of Independence Day celebrations in America, beginning with the 4th of July, completed by the 19th of June.
Hmm. So what have the organization that you are part of have been doing in the way of bringing the attention to Juneteenth?
Well, working with Juneteenth organizations and leaders across the country in the modern Juneteenth movement, we have 29 states now that recognize Juneteenth as a state holiday or a state holiday observance. Texas began the legislative recognition of Juneteenth in 1979 with legislation passed by Representative Al Edwards to make Juneteenth a paid state holiday in Texas, followed by Florida, Oklahoma, Delaware was the fourth state where we began the campaign, and now Vermont is the 29th state to recognize Juneteenth as a state holiday observance. So we're not necessarily asking for a paid federal holiday where all these federal employees are off from work, or a paid state holiday, but a special day of observance. And we've been successful with 29 states, and then also in 1997, the 105th Congress, with the leadership of, believe it or not, Mississippi Senator Trent Lott, passed the first historic legislation recognizing Juneteenth as Juneteenth Independence Day in the United States, followed by J.C. Watts in the House. And so we're trying now to make it an official national holiday observance, sort of similar to what the Flag Day is, where it's a special day of observance, not necessarily a paid federal holiday, and certainly its time is long overdue.
You just mentioned two Republicans, J.C. Watt and Trent Lott. What about Democrats? What have Democrats done? I think Deval Patrick of Massachusetts have done some things on that.
Two years ago, the governor of Massachusetts signed legislation to make Juneteenth a state holiday observance in Massachusetts. An initial footnote in history when it came to the recognition of Juneteenth in Congress, the Republicans were very supportive, in fact, sponsored the first legislation for the holiday recognition in 1997. Trent Lott, the Phil Graham, was amazing. The number of Republicans that came and supported this recognition of Juneteenth, including Newt Gingrich. But the heroine, I would say, of the Juneteenth legislation was in 1996. Former Congressman Barbara Rose Collins was successful in getting the House of Representatives to recognize Juneteenth, and then followed in 1997 by the Senate, and then again back in the House. But Democrats were not really the main members of Congress who supported Juneteenth in the beginning, but certainly as we've moved more and more legislation to the state, we have a number of Democratic supporters now. Illinois is a Juneteenth is recognized as a state holiday observance. Congressman Danny Davis from Illinois is the National Juneteenth Congressional Chairman, and Barack Obama is the Senate host. And so now we enjoy 29 states, members of Congress, Republican and Democrats, are working to make Juneteenth a state holiday observance and a national holiday in all 50 states.
This is Opio, and I'm speaking to Reverend Dr. Ronnie Myers of the National Juneteenth Celebration Campaign. Barack Obama may be the next president of the United States. Do you believe that he will sign Juneteenth legislation into law?
Oh, most definitely. Senator Obama was a strong supporter of Juneteenth as a state senator in Illinois, where he was instrumental in getting the legislation through the legislature there, recognizing Juneteenth as a state holiday observance. And certainly he's been one of our major supporters in Congress since he's been a United States Senator. He speaks every year at our Juneteenth Congressional Reception, which is part of the Washington Juneteenth National Holiday Observance. And certainly it will be a great change from President Bush, who won't even open his mouth and say anything about Juneteenth, say anything about the end of slavery. A former governor of Texas, where he presides over a statewide Juneteenth commission, he has never said one word, one personal word, or said anything about the importance of Juneteenth and the recognition of Juneteenth. Yes, he goes to the Africa, my brother, and sits on the West Coast there on the door of no return, and talks about American slavery, but won't open his mouth in this country. In fact, New York Times had an editorial that was saying that the African leaders must find it quite strange that the leader of America would come to Africa to talk about American slavery, but only mention it, and won't even talk about it back here in America.
Mm.
So Barack Obama will be a fresh air, a breath of fresh air, in terms of acknowledging America sitting in the Senate.
Why do you believe that some of the roadblocks have been put up in the way of Juneteenth, whether it's George Bush or any local or national leaders?
Well, certainly, you know, America needs healing from the legacy of slavery. That's why we have the National Day of Reconciliation and Healing from the Legacy of Slavery on the third Friday in June, and also the National Juneteenth Black Holocaust MIAFA Memorial Service. MIAFA means Swahili term for terrible occurrence, a great disaster, to talk about and remember our middle passage, the thousands of our people who died from lynchings and murders, millions and millions passes. So America needs healing, and the healing also begins with us as African Americans, because a lot of us have a hard time even accepting slavery. And so with a lot of resistance amongst us, because we don't want to deal with the legacy of slavery, be affiliated or associated with slavery. And then certainly America, in many ways, does not want to recognize the whole history of legacy of slavery. So America's going through a process. That's why Juneteenth is so important. Look what happened when Congressman Tony Hall made efforts for the Congress to apologize for slavery. His last effort was on June 19th, the year 2000, during the first annual National Men's Reconciliation Meeting for the Legacy of Slavery. He was not successful. So certainly, America needs healing. America needs to come to a understanding about the history of slavery and its effects still to this day.
How do you believe we should begin talking to children about Juneteenth and slavery, not only in our homes, but in schools?
Well, certainly, Juneteenth is a historic American celebration of freedom. It certainly should be taught right in the schools. In fact, we're trying to get the Juneteenth book placed in every public school library, in every public library in the country. And this book talks about the history of Juneteenth and what it all means. But it needs to be taught right with the curriculum in the schools. When we talk about the 4th of July, we need to be talking about the 19th of June, because both days are significant when it comes to the history of American Independence Days and freedom celebrations in America. So I would say it should be an important footnote in history at home. Our children need to understand their history in terms of our going from slavery to freedom. And certainly they need to understand that in America, they do share freedom, but that came at a tremendous cost. And it's only then when we take the responsibility of handing our history down accurately, and it's our responsibility to do that to African Americans, will our children fully understand and appreciate the freedoms and the struggle ahead that they have, and that we sacrificed so much to make the world better for them.
Now, here in Portland next Saturday, there will be a parade and there will be festivities. Tell me what the typical Juneteenth celebration looks like. What are some of the symbols and what are some of the events that are held?
Well, Juneteenth traditionally is celebrated with parades, celebrated with food, also music, but some celebrations consist of the raising of the Juneteenth flag at City Hall or at the library or important places in the community, and the reading of the Emancipation Proclamation, and on to, like I said, music, food, floats. Some Juneteenth celebrations, the one in Hattiesburg, Mississippi, has over 40 floats. The one in Chicago. It's amazing now, some of the largest Juneteenth celebrations in the country are outside of Mississippi. In fact, Minnesota, for instance, has one of the largest Juneteenth celebrations in America. So it depends on what that particular region or what that particular celebration is emphasizing. But certainly, a celebration consisting of music, food, parades, certainly on the level of America's second Independence Day, and it's beginning to be observed all across the country, all 50 states.
Now, some people don't know how that Juneteenth flag looks. Describe the Juneteenth flag and tell people where they can go to take a look at the Juneteenth flag.
Well, we have a website, www.juneteenthflag.com, or you can go to www.juneteenth.us. The creator of the Juneteenth flag was Ben Haight. He's the director of the Massachusetts efforts to make Juneteenth a state and national holiday. And what Ben did was he took the U.S. flag, which had 50 stars representing the 50 states. He took the star of Texas and put it in the middle of his own flag. Texas colors are red, white, and blue, so he put a half blue, half red top and bottom, and a border around the star representing the news of freedom spread from Texas to the rest of the country. And that is a lot of times displayed with the U.S. flag, where the flag for the U.S. flag represents the 4th of July, the Juneteenth flag with the symbolism of the star of Texas with the border where news for freedom spread, and its red top, blue bottom represents the 19th of June.
All right, now, give us more information on how people can learn more about Juneteenth and Are there any other words that you would like to say to encourage those who are locally in this area that are promoting and will be attending Juneteenth festivities next weekend?
Well, I am very excited to hear about the important celebration. I think it's particularly in that area of the country, more and more celebrations are growing. And to find information out about the National Juneteenth Holiday Campaign, again, our website is www.juneteenth.us, not us. And we have petition drives that we are organizing for all the Juneteenth celebrations across the country. If you go to juneteenth.us, you can get a copy of the petition, actually get printed up, get it signed, and get the petition on to Washington, D.C. I encourage everyone to contact their congressional delegation and their member of Congress, the two United States senators, because certainly they should be present at those celebrations and certainly be acknowledging those celebrations. And we have the Congressional Juneteenth reception. They should certainly be make an attempt to attend the reception, which is at the U.S. Capitol. So it's important that we understand our legacy of freedom in America came from the struggle for slavery to freedom. And as President Douglas said, and spoke so eloquently, what to the slave is your 4th of July? And if you hear going, the President Douglas own words, 4th of July is yours, not mine. And Juneteenth, the 19th of June, is ours. It's our day of celebration of freedom and independence in America.
Yeah, he also said power proceeds nothing without a demand.
Got to make a demand, brother.
Yes, sir. All right, Reverend Dr. Ronnie Myers, thank you, sir.
Thank you.